communicating each other, right? We are all using various things to communicate, like mobile phones, computer, and everything, right? So like that, in our body, we have a communication system which is known as our nervous system, okay? And today we will learn about the nervous system in our body. So can we start? First of all, what are nerves and what is nervous system? Nervous system has a very important role in our body. I already told you that nervous system act as a communication system in our body. So they collect various messages from various parts of our body and give it to the brain. So it is related with our brain, our spinal cord, and our sense organ, everything, right? So what are nerves? So you can see in that picture, there are nerves are like fibers, right? They are like threads. So nerves are made up of a bundle of fibers, too many fibers together, it makes a nervous system in our body. So nervous system connects with our brain, sense organs, spinal cord, right? So first of all, there are three kinds of nerves in our body. They are sensory nerves, motor nerves, and visceral nerves. So sensory nerves are those nerves which are carrying messages from sense organs to our brain. So sensory, and which is related to sense organs. And you all know about our sense organs. And when we start to learn about science, the first thing we learn about our sense organs. So sensory nerves, which are carries messages from sense organs to our brain. And the next is motor nerve. Motor nerve carries messages from our brain to our muscles. We all have muscles now, so to the muscles and our spinal cord. And next is mixed nerve. Mixed nerves carry messages to the brain as well as brings messages for the brain. So it carries messages from the brain and it takes messages from various parts of the body and brings it to our brain. So I already told you our nervous system is connected with our brain also. Okay? So but brain has a very important role in our body. Why? Because brain regulates all the activities in our body. Like if you want to sleep, cry, play, even I am teaching you that all activities are controlled by our brain. So you can see the structure of brain. Look at this. This is the structure of our body, right? And this is here we can see the brain. Okay? This is the brain. So look at this. The brain is protected by this structure, right? And the brain has a structure like walnut. Walnut you all know, na? It's a dry fruit and you all like it, right? So walnut, we can see in walnut there is an outermost shell, na? So it means inner side we have that walnut piece and outer side it has a covering. Like that, same thing, brain has also an outer covering which is known as skull. What? Skull. It is a body structure and it protects our brain. And this is the brain, right? In an adult person, the brain has a weight in between 1 to 1.5 kg. And the brain has three parts. These are the three parts. This is the cerebrum, and this is cerebellum, and this is medulla. So these are the three main parts of the brain. And you can see, the cerebrum is the largest part in our brain, which is covered by the 90% of our brain, and it controls our memory, our thoughts, and it also controls our sense organs. And this is cerebellum. Cerebellum is the smallest part. Why? We already told that 90% of our brain is consists of our cerebellum. So cerebellum is the smallest part and it coordinates movements of our muscles like this kind of movements are controlled by, and our postures like we stand, we sit, everything is controlled by our cerebellum. And the medulla is the lower part of the brain. And medulla, look at this. Medulla is here will be the medulla and it is connected to the spinal cord of our body. So it control the breathing and circulation movement of our body. These are the nerves, right? These are the nerves. So, the next is our spinal cord. Spinal cord has a very important role in our body. You can see, this is a thin tube-like structure which is start from the brain and it is end up with our waist. So, start from the brain and ends in our waist. So, it has a very important importance in our body because whatever message we want to send to brain, it all collects in the spinal cord. Then, spinal cord gives it everywhere in the body. If the message part goes to brain, it will reach the messages to brain and another part leads to the another part of the body. So, one thing, for example, if we want to touch any means hot object or cold object, what will happen? Suddenly we take back our hands, right? If any hot object we are touching like that, suddenly we move back our hands, right? So, why it becomes like that? Do you think about that? That action is known as reflex action. Means we will get a message that it is very hot, we can't touch that. If we touch it, our hands will burn, right? So we will get that message. That message is going from where? Spinal cord. So the reflex action is always related with our spinal cord. So these are the function of the spinal cord in our body. Next, sense organs. You all know about the sense organs. There are 5 sense organs in our body. They are eyes, nose, ears, tongue and skin. Okay? So these are the 5 sense organs in our body. The sense organs also has very important because the first sense organ is our eyes. If we want to see something, we need eyes, right? So it has very important role. And the eyes is in a circular shape. And the eyelids, these are the eyelids, right? Eyelids help the eyes prevent some dust, germs which are entered into the eyes, eyelashes, protect the eyes from that. And the ear is also very important because if we want to hear the sound, we need our ears. Ear has 3 parts, outer ear, middle ear and inner ear. And the next is nose. You all know that if we want to smell, breathe, everything, we need our nose. And the next is tongue. Tongue is a very important sense organ because if we want to taste something, we need our tongue, right? If we want to taste some toffee, otherwise some juices, everything we need is tongue. And the tongue has a small bumps-like structure which is known as taste buds. Taste buds help us to taste the things, right? And the next is skin. Skin is the outermost covering of our body and it protects our body from outside, from germs, dirt and everything, right? The skin consists of 2 parts which are the outer layer and the inner layer. Thank you.